for the 2013 edition of the Peterson Caterpillar Washougal National.
The 32nd board is up. Are you ready for the finals of the 450 class?
The gate is on the ground, and in the turn number one they come. Is it going to be Ryan Dungey? Is it going to be Ryan Villopoto? And it looks like Yamaha mounted pilot almost gets off the bike, and Ryan Dungey gets into the number one position. I don't believe Dungey had the whole shot, but he does now have the number one spot as he heads to the top of the mountain. Dungey's into the number one spot, but Villopoto is right in tow. Here comes Villopoto now, down off the hill into the number two position. It looks like the 33 of Josh Grant into the number three spot. And James Stewart is right there as well. In and out of the catcher's mitt they go. Dungey and Villopoto, now Stewart, now Grant. Grant moves into the number four position. It is Jake Weimer now to the number five ride. Over to the left side of the racetrack they come. Watch them, folks, in and out of the trees they go. All of a sudden, Ryan Dungey's got company, and it's Ryan Villopoto. Villopoto out of Poulsbo, Washington, coming up onto the rear wheel of the KTM. The KTM gets the green flag. Flag number one is in the books. And Ryan Dungey ahead of Ryan Villopoto, going one and two. Stewart now back into the number three position. Into the number four line they go. That far side of the facility they come. They're all the way at the bottom of the racetrack in terms of elevation. And now, in and out of the S-turns. They're heading now through the Thor Parts Unlimited Arch and now to the mechanics area where Georgia Lindsay is waiting.
Yes, I'm down here. We've just been passed by the number one of Ryan Dungey, Ryan Villopoto.
Top of the mountain they go, Rob Bynus, and they are out of sight. They climbed all the way up Horsepower Hill. That's a left-handed sweeper. As you can see them, the sun is out up there. The glare is tremendous. Around the sweeper they come, and now they jump back down into the center of Washougal, Washington, and here comes Ryan Villopoto!
Villopoto has himself in the number two spot. That would give him second overall, but he'd lose 6 points to Dungey. He doesn't want to do that. They've had a lot of races this year where they've split points. And right now, rider number two, Ryan Villopoto, sits in second, and Dungey, number one, is out front.
Here comes our front runner now from Georgia Lindsay into the mechanics area. We are still looking at Ryan Dungey. Here come both Ryans as Villopoto tries to get onto the infield, the inside of Dungey. Dungey will not let that happen. Atop the KTM, and Villopoto is right behind him. Ryan Villopoto is stalking Ryan Dungey here today. Go. into the number one ride. We are still looking at Ryan Dungey. In and out of the S-turns, they're heading up Horsepower Hill. It's Dungey and Villopoto and Stewart. 1, 2, and 3 with Grant in 4.
In and out of the Red Bull corner with the monster right behind him. Ryan Villopoto, rider number 2, the red number plate background. And Ryan Dungey leads Villopoto up in the tree line. The first moto very overcast. Tim Potter, this one, a lot of sun out. So many shadows on the track. Your goggles are going to be paramount for helping you pick a good line.
It's going to be challenging today. That's why many of these riders are using Oakley goggles. That sun coming in and out of those trees, it's like a strobe light in your helmet for these riders as they make their way off the hill. In and out of the S-turns they come, and checking in for yet another lap. We are now 5 minutes and 49 seconds into moto number 2. Here come the front runners now. Here comes Ryan Dungey, the Dunge, holding on to the number 1 ride. Villopoto into the number 2 position. Villopoto right on the rear wheel. But how about Ryan Villopoto and Ryan Dungey? Their lap times are nearly exact. They are within a couple of 100ths of one another. Back into the center of this racetrack and watch them as they climb the mountain. They are trekking all the way to the top of the summit here at Washougal, Washington. Ryan Dungey's got the lead right now. He had the whole shot in moto number 1. I don't know that he was the whole shot winner here in moto number 2. I believe Josh Grant may have had that one here in moto number 2, but it wasn't long after, when I say not long, like 10, 12 feet past that threshold, that all of a sudden Ryan Dungey took over the number 1 spot. Here they come off the hill now into the catcher's mitt with Rob Bidens.
The Ryan. Dungey out front, Villopoto in second. Right now they're going on alphabetical order. We'll see if they can't sort this one out before we get to 30 minutes plus 2 laps. James Stewart has lost a little bit of touch with that lead too. He rides all alone in spot number 3.
Still Ryan Dungey, but here comes Villopoto now. Villopoto goes to the inside, and Villopoto took a line away from Ryan Dungey. Dungey got a little bit to the left, left the door open for Ryan Villopoto, and so mark it down with 8 minutes and 26 seconds gone in moto number 2. Ryan Villopoto takes over the lead. Here comes Dungey now. He's right on the rear wheel. He will not let loose.
Dungey sits right behind Villopoto, just taking a whole bunch of roof from that factory Kawasaki. Ryan Villopoto now with a 2-1 on the day that share points with 47, but Villopoto would take the elusive overall that has eluded him since he turned to pro. A lot of racing yet to go. Can Ryan Dungey battle back?
Two different lines going up Horsepower Hill now. All the way to the top of the mountain they go. To the sweeper to the left. Around the left side of the racetrack, Ryan Dungey, Ryan Villopoto, Villopoto, and then Dungey.
Thank you.
back into the number one spot is Ryan Villopoto. He continues to hold on to the number one ride all the way to the top of half the arc. They are coming back down. They'll be heading into the catcher's mitt here just momentarily. As the number two, Ryan Villopoto, coming out of the shaded area into the sun area, then quickly back into the shaded area. Again, the sunlight beaming through the trees here is like a strobe light. That's why many of these riders have chosen Oakley goggles here today. They're supreme technology to keep that glare out and to keep the good vision. These riders are watching in high depth as they make their way around this racetrack. It is Ryan Dungey who is sitting into the number two position. Villopoto now has pulled out 2.448 seconds over Ryan Dungey after lap number six. We are 12 minutes, 43 seconds in to moto number two here today for the Peterson Cat Washougal National. Ryan Villopoto and Dungey and Stewart, 1, 2, and 3. Weimer now moved into the number four ride as Josh Grant on the JGR. Joe Gibbs Yamaha has dropped into that number four position, or number five position rather. Chad Reed has made it into the number six spot. Into the number seven ride is Brock Tickle and Nicoletti in eight. Andrew Short in nine. Mike Alessi rounds out the top 10.
Villopoto does start to open up quite a gap right now over Dungey as Dungey has started to settle into that number two spot, and Villopoto continues to charge. Ryan Villopoto going for his first overall as a professional here at Washougal in the pro class.
We go. Ryan Villopoto has just checked in. He still holds a good lead over Ryan Dungey, but Dungey can keep him in his sights. Dungey is not let loose. He is not faded to the point where he is more than a turn away from one another. So Dungey and Villopoto, and now Stewart has checked in some 13 seconds behind Ryan Dungey. He is 17 seconds out of the lead. In and out of the S turns they come. Thank you. Villopoto, Dungy, and Stewart have checked in. Jake Weimer coming by the number 12 Kawasaki as he makes his way through the rockers here. Yeah, the sun is starting to beam out here today. The temperature's going up.
Race out there with a lot of very, very good riders. And speaking of good riders, how about the two of Ryan Villopoto? He's opened up a lead over Dungy. Dungy's an incredible national champion, incredible rider himself.
Front runners as they've gone to the top of the hill. Now they're heading back down into the catcher's mitt. Thank you. Villopoto was able to get around Dungy earlier in the program was able to stay out there. But Ryan Dungy staying within striking distance. If something were to happen with Villopoto, a lap rider, a bobble, what have you, Dungy would be right there. This next time around for Ryan Villopoto. Where's number two here today from Poolsbo, Washington, his home event. Ryan Villopoto has an opportunity to do something that he has never done before. That is win an overall here at Washougal, Washington. Have come off the hill. Waiting on the number two of Ryan Villopoto. Making his way down towards the finish line area with a red number plate. That tells you he is the current points leader. And Villopoto crosses the stripe here in Washougal. Ryan Dungy comes across into the number two position. Two of Ryan Villopoto heading his way up to the top of the hill. Villopoto Ryan Dungey, James Stewart, 1, 2, and 3, and that's the way it's going to look when it's all said and done. The checkered flag is about to come out for the number 2 of Ryan Villopoto, your hometown rider, as he clenches his fist in the air. Ryan Villopoto out of Poolsbow, Washington, has won it here in his home track. The first time ever for an overall for Villopoto here in Washington.
Here, but never was able to win the overall. So finally got that out of the way now. So that's feels good.
So